Hello friends, welcome to Export Import Learning Channel. Today in this session we will understand job profile of the export manager. Okay, so here the position of the assistant manager for the export import documentation. Okay, so by this session we will understand the working scenario of the export manager. What activities are important in the import in this process scenario, what we have to follow the instructions. So we will understand all the thing one by one. So here if we see the job profile, the basic responsibility in this job profile is prepare all export documentation within the required time frame. So here we need to understand time frame means that at the given time we have to dispatch some specific goods. Okay, so for that we have to prepare the set of document in the same time. Just like there are some activities we need to follow in export, like before dispatching the goods we have to file the checklist and approve it. Okay, and also taking the follow up with the transporter and arrange the container and truck for the goods movement to the custom. Okay, so in this stipulate time we need to fulfill these activities. Okay, prepare all export documents mean here we have to prepare the set of document which require for the custom purpose, like a commercial invoice, packing list, tax invoice, annexures. This set of documents used for the custom purpose. Okay, another line is mentioned here, timeline and schedules, efficient shipping activities to identify appropriate transportation methods accordance with the customer. Okay, so in this job there are particular type of goods exported, the dimension of goods are different. So here we need to identify the appropriate transport, like what type of container we need to book so this goods can be export in right way. Okay, if shipment is small, then we try to book the container LCL shipment so the freight cost will be low. Okay, so if shipment is very urgent, then we will send it by air mode. So appropriate transportation need to check is very very important. Okay, to saving time and cost and the customer delivery. Okay, so this is important. If you go to next, ensure compliance with all procedure. Okay, so here ensure compliance mean we have to check out the all compliance is fulfilling correctly or not. So if we talk about compliance, that compliance first with rules and regulation with the custom. Okay, working procedures of the custom, what they require documents for the custom clearance. So we need to check out. So here we need to ensure that the all working activities are as per compliance or not, means as per government rules and regulation or not. Okay, and monitors our financial and currency process of import export current country. Okay, so here we can say that the compliance with the bank also require, just like a compliance, like a, we are export some goods from India to other country. So in the case of FOC, there is no foreign currency comes as if we are sending the sample to the our buyer. So what compliance will we need to fulfill? We need to give the GR waiver to the custom and informing that we are sending this goods for the sample purpose. So this is the compliance. Okay, on monitor our financial currency and process of import export country. So here some countries are have a crisis of the specific type of currency like USD and other currency, so that some countries are restrict the import. So we need to keep in mind that what is the appropriate action to be taken at right time. So in this case we need to understand the situations of the import and export, and we can say other financial currencies process is import export is like if we are going to export some good and we need to fulfill the compliance of the bank, like we have to submit the document against payment in case of export. For example, some payment received in advance and bank have issued the FIRC against that payment, then we have to submit the document in respect of that payment. Okay, so this is the procedures and compliance with the custom and bank. The next point is expertise in the sea freight. Here, expertise in sea freight means that we have to take the competitive rate from the our freight forwarders. Okay, means expertise in sea freight. Just like choose the specific type of transport, they give efficient service. Okay, not high prices, but best services. Okay, in good price, the best service provided. We choose the appropriate type of the transport. So in this scenario, we should have a good CHN freight forwarder. They provide efficient transport in timely and deliver the goods as per timeline. Okay, so expertise in sea freight means that we have a good service provider. Okay, and air documentations. For the air documentation process, we need good supply, good CHS. He know the good knowledge of the air documentation. Okay, by the way, at the dispatch document, we self prepare our documents and it will be examined at the custom level and check and verify. So ensure all documents are correctly. Okay, we have to check the all document, the documents are correct or not. So if you go to next process, document related to commercial invoice by validating data integrity and accuracy. We need to understand this is very important point. Process, document related commercial invoice. Okay, the document which related to the commercial invoice, we have to validate the data integrity and accuracy. Just like which documents depend on the commercial invoice. First document is shipping bill, another is a bill of lading. So while we filing the shipping bill, we have to check and verify the checklist. Okay, so in this, we have to validate the data which is mentioned in the checklist is accurately matching with the commercial invoice. Otherwise, we will face problem like exporter address, importer address, description of the goods, net weight, gross weight, value of the goods, inco terms, payment terms. These are the data which we need to check and verify before filing shipping bill in the EDI with accuracy. Okay, and another type of document which is related to the commercial is bill of lading. So when we give the shipping instruction to the shipping line, the all details mentioned in the shipping line in the bill of lading must be matched with the commercial invoice. Okay, now next, responsibility analysis and negotiate shipping cost. Okay, with freight forwarder on the basis of weight and consignment volume. Okay, so here this is the very good point at the time of current. Just like we have a good CHS and which give us the competitive rate. Like if we are going to export a 20 kg packet, then we will take rate from 3CHA. The CHA who provide the best rate, we will give the shipment to that particular CHA. Okay, so in this case, what we will do before dispatching, we will take the rate from our CHA 3-4 whatever you have CHA which give best rate. So we will ask the rate for the 20 kg of box and we will share the destination. So they give rate and we will choose better best prices and rate quotations. Okay, from freight forwarder. Okay, as per the weight and consignment volume. Okay, and we analysis and negotiate the same and give the shipment to particular CHM. Now, verifying freight receiving against receipt invoice and documentation. Okay, in this scenario, what we do when we export the goods, we receive the shipping line invoices as a freight invoice, as a freight invoice, which we have to pay the freight to the shipping line. In some cases, if we hire the CHA, if he's also providing freight forwarding service, so we directly not pay to the shipping line. In this case, we will pay to a freight forwarder and take service, and freight forwarder pay to the shipping line. Okay, so in this process, when we receive the bills for the freight and clearance, we will check out the bills against the receipt and all documents. Sign for cargo using correct time, date, signature. Okay, so this is the process of dispatching while we dispatch the goods from our factory. So we will take, we will get signed from our authorized person who is authorized for the same, as a shipping manager or whatever. So in dispatching the goods, before we prepare the setup document, we need to check out and properly and get signed from our senior. Okay. But in this case, you are the responsible for that activity because this is a job profile for the assistant manager of the export. Okay. Next, check out, check inbound documentation for currency accuracy period to receptions and annotate receiving document with the storage overseas and damage. Okay. It is very important, just like a when we receive some shipment from other country, it parallelly we receive the document of intimation that our supplier intimate us that we have sent these goods. Okay, so is along with the shipment, he also send the documents in email. So what we do, we need to file the checklist. Okay, in accurate time period, else custom will fine us. Just like if the document not receive us and the goods receive before the document, we will not able to find the bill of entry. So in this case, the storage and overseas and damage and over charges will be applied. Okay. In this case, there is another, we have to check out at reception that what documents are receiving as a inbound, like some shipping document received, just a bill of lading, commercial invoice, sorry, certificate of residence and insurance. This document is received physically. So we have to check at the reception, any documents which are important and related to the export, we have to check out in the reception and process the same. Next, provide advice on the most affordable mode of transport to facilitate cost effectiveness. So here we will, if we are exporting some goods from our country to other country, so we will discuss with our senior and advise to them the most affordable mode of transport. Like if we are dispatching goods to the Bangladesh, so if we send goods through the by sea, what will be cost? And if we send by the road, then what will be cost? And if we send this good by the air, so what will be cost? So we analysis this cost, okay, and select the affordable mode of transport, which is good for company. So guys, in this session, we have understood working procedure of the assistant manager of the export. Okay, guys, so in this way, if we are going for any job, we have to know this job description and read and aware with these procedures so that we can crack the interview. So guys, thank you for watching the session. Have a nice day.